Hi, it's Katrina. From rhinos that are so endangered even scientists have never seen them, to giant apex predators of the sea, here are 10 animals you probably won't see in a zoo or aquarium anytime soon. Number 10. Blobfish. When scientists pulled up this grumpy blob thing, they were pretty surprised. What was it? The blobfish lives in the deep waters off of New Zealand. It lives in such deep water that it's adapted to pressures that would crush the innards of lesser fish, which is why you won't see them in an aquarium. Recreating the environment of the deep ocean is not really that plausible yet. Their bodies are mostly gelatinous with a density just slightly lighter than water, which allows them to float right above the seabed. This is good because they have almost no muscle. They aren't hunters so much as living vacuums, just sucking in whatever floats by their mouths. Because they're adapted to pressures that are almost 120 times what we experience at the surface, blobfish that get caught in fishing nets suffer decompression like a diver. This affects how they look, making them look more like a grumpy old man than a fish. But this is because of the pressure differential. In their own environment, maybe they look great. Actually, scientists have reported that they look more like normal fish, although they're still incredibly ugly. They are actually ambassadors for the Ugly Animal Preservation Society, and there is even a book called Ugly Animals, We Can't All Be Pandas, by Simon Watt, with a collection of 60 of the world's most ugly and endangered animals, and the blobfish is on the front cover. Number 9. Saola. If you've never heard of the saola, don't worry, you're not alone. This extremely rare antelope-like mammal, nicknamed the Asian unicorn, was not discovered until 1992 and hasn't really been seen that often since. In fact, not a single biologist or conservation expert has ever seen one in the wild, and it was last captured on camera in the wild in 1999. The saola only lives in the Annamite mountain range located along the border of Laos and Vietnam and is critically endangered, which is why it is not found in any zoos. A captive saola died in 2010, days after villagers in a remote region of Laos took it into their care. Government authorities had hurriedly dispatched a team to examine and release the animal, but they did not make it there on time. While no zoo has ever cared for a saola, over 22 zoos and related organizations throughout Europe and North America have cumulatively pledged hundreds of thousands of dollars to help save it. The donations, totaling over $350,000, will go toward a planned breeding center, which the IUCN Species Survival Commission Saola Working Group refers to as the last best hope for rescuing this unique animal from the brink of extinction. The Saola Working Group has made impressive strides when it comes to protecting its habitat, but commercial poaching remains an ever-present threat to this unusual mammal. Because of this, the estimated surviving wild saola population numbers less than 100. Number 8. The Indri. The Indri is a rare and unique primate that is also called the babakoto. It's among the largest of the lemur species, reaching between 13 and 21 pounds, and, like all lemurs, is only found in Madagascar. Unlike most other lemurs who have tails as long as their bodies, the Indri has a short tail, measuring just 2 inches long, despite its body growing between 25 and 28 inches long. Relying on trees to travel from point A to point B, these adorably unique creatures are limited to very specific habitats, namely lowland and coastal rainforests. They live mostly in the Anjanaharibe Sud Wildlife Preserve, located in the island's northeast region, so you can imagine that the area is not that big. According to the New England Primate Conservancy, an Indri has never survived more than a year in captivity. This is mainly because the species cannot tolerate even mild disturbances in its environment. The organization's website says that its diet is extremely specialized. The animal eats certain foods at certain times of day, a level of specificity that cannot be replicated in captivity. Also, when taken from the wild, these lemurs, for reasons which remain unclear, do not reproduce. Another interesting fact about the Indri's reproductive habits is that these creatures are monogamous. They mate for life and do not seek out another partner until their current one passes away. The Indri's natural habitat is threatened by logging and agriculture, heavily restricting the species to protected forests. And now for number 7. But first, which animal would you like to see up close? Do you like going to the zoo? Let me know in the comments below and be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. Number 7. Pink Fairy Armadillo. The cryptic pink fairy armadillo is only found in central Argentina. It's nocturnal, solitary, subterranean, and just 6 inches long on average. A 2012 study, which cited the species as among the most elusive mammals, stated that their basic biology and evolutionary history remain virtually unknown. Although this mysterious creature is rarely seen in the wild, and scientists know very little about it, the pink fairy armadillo literally cannot survive in captivity. This much is evident in the many failed attempts at removing it from the wild and placing it in confinement, both as an illegal pet and at zoos. Pink fairy armadillos rarely survive more than a few years at zoos, according to the San Diego Zoo, and that's more or less the animal's best-case scenario in captivity. They typically die within 8 days of being removed from their natural environment. A 2011 study found that any modifications to the pink fairy armadillo's environment or diet caused a great deal of stress to the animal, a glaringly obvious sign that it is best left undisturbed by humans. Unfortunately, like several animals on today's list, the pink fairy armadillo is threatened by human activity, particularly habitat loss due to farming. As a burrowing creature, things like the plowing of farmland and grazing cattle have an enormous impact on its habitat, while at the same time pesticides are increasingly killing the insects it feeds on. So it's kind of in trouble if efforts aren't made to save it. Number 6. The narwhal. Perhaps the real-life unicorn, narwhals are toothed whales that live in cold Arctic waters. Its long ivory tusk was prized in the past, and explorers that brought back this horn to Europe perhaps created the legend of the magical unicorn and its horn. Several aquariums attempted to house narwhals during the 60s and 70s, but they all died within months, despite having an average lifespan of 50 years in the wild. In 1969, a baby narwhal named Umiak, who had recently been put on display at the New York Aquarium in Coney Island, Brooklyn, passed away. The tragic loss reportedly surprised Nixon Griffiths, the aquarium's assistant director, who described Umiak as friendly and seemingly comfortable in the tank's 54-degree Fahrenheit water. Numerous factors may have contributed to Umiak's untimely demise. For one, the young creature was without its mother, that Inuits had hunted in Arctic waters. The aquarium attempted to pair the baby with a stepmother, a white whale roughly the size of Umiak's natural mother, and although the narwhal's cause of death was undetermined, its pseudo-mom and artificial environment clearly were not enough to meet the animal's needs. They also have very unique behavior that we still don't quite understand. Sometimes many of them will get together by the thousands to migrate and float and jump out of the water. No matter how big a glass box is, it's not enough for this. Umiak is just one example of a narwhal failing to thrive in captivity. In fact, not a single one has survived. Aquariums around the world eventually acknowledged that it would be extremely difficult and expensive to keep them. Number 5. Mountain gorilla. Throughout the 60s and 70s, numerous attempts were made at capturing and breeding mountain gorillas. This was definitely the time for zoos to be experimenting. Even more disturbingly, many adult specimens were killed in order to obtain live babies to be able to raise them, according to the International Gorilla Conservation Program. However, while lowland gorillas survive in captivity, mountain gorillas have not, including the stolen babies. There are currently no known mountain gorillas under human care. The reasons for this species' inability to thrive in confinement, beyond the obvious fact that they're wild animals who belong in their natural habitat, are unclear. Some possibilities are that mountain gorillas have more complex dietary needs or are more affected by stress, and therefore more susceptible to disease than lowland gorillas. Although there are no mountain gorillas in captivity, people wishing to see one can take guided tours through the animal's environment in Uganda, Rwanda, and the Democratic Republic of the Congo, for now at least. Habitat loss and disease are the primary threats to this endangered species, but poaching is also a problem. Number 4. Great White Shark. The great white shark is another famously failed experiment. This disappoints many people who would understandably love to see one of these terrifying apex predators up close at their local aquarium, but there are good reasons for leaving them in the wild. This apex predator never survives for long in captivity. As dangerous as great whites are in nature, aquariums don't keep these impressive creatures mainly for their safety. Past attempts have resulted in the great white refusing to eat, needing help swimming, and displaying other obvious signs of distress such as smashing into the glass walls. Their health then immediately begins to decline and they die after spending just days or weeks in confinement. The longest a great white has ever survived in captivity is 198 days at the Monterey Bay Aquarium in California. Despite being placed in a massive 3.78 million liter tank designed for open ocean animals, the small young shark did not have enough space to swim around in. Great whites travel around the whole world. As it grew, its dietary needs also became increasingly demanding. The aquarium released the shark 6 months after first displaying it because it killed two of its tank mates, which were sharks of other species. Put simply, great whites just travel too much naturally to be contained, even in an extremely large tank. They're constantly on the move because their oxygen intake depends on it, and are therefore accustomed to traveling great distances in short amounts of time, which no aquarium can realistically accommodate. The Monterey Bay Aquarium finally ended its great white program in 2011. A Japanese aquarium attempted to exhibit a great white in 2016, but the shark died after 3 days, and the aquarium wisely ended their program as well. Thankfully, great whites have largely fallen out of favor as potential residents at these institutions, which have apparently finally realized that they simply do not survive in glass. Number 3. Javan Rhino. The extremely rare Javan rhino, endemic to Indonesia, is the world's rarest large mammal. On average, it reaches over 5 feet tall at the shoulder and weighs almost 2 tons. Despite its massive size, this solitary creature is incredibly shy and feeds mostly on twigs, shoots, and fruit. The Javan rhino is critically endangered, with the world's only remaining viable population numbering between 68 and 72, living in Indonesia's remote Ujung Kulon National Park, or UKNP. The park is near its maximum capacity for the number of rhinos it can hold, according to Global Wildlife Conservation, and there are none in captivity. In 1883, the nearby Anak Krakatau volcano erupted, destroying much of UKNP and its surrounding environment. The volcano is currently active and erupted as recently as December 2018, resulting in an ensuing tsunami. While no Javan rhinos were harmed during this last close call, their safety from future natural disasters is far from guaranteed. Not only is it unlikely for a tourist or ordinary person to see a Javan rhino, many scientists have traveled quite far in hopes of seeing one and gone home disappointed after failing to spot one. Besides being rare, this critically endangered species is incredibly elusive and lives in a dense tropical rainforest habitat. Number 2. Swallows. Swallows are actually common and incredibly versatile birds who can adapt to an impressive variety of habitats, including meadows, pastures, woodlands, grasslands, parks, sports fields, and gardens. But captivity is typically not one of them. While swallows occasionally take up headquarters in man-made structures such as barns and can adapt decently to life in urban environments, they are not well-suited for zoos or as pets, and we have not domesticated them in any way. In other words, they prefer open habitats that do not restrict their movement and where they can come and go as they please. In the words of naturalist David Mizejewski of the National Wildlife Federation, swallows are so focused on flying, they're delicate and they don't thrive in captivity. Another reason swallows are not ideal zoo animals is because they capture their food mid-air. Keeping them captive requires a very large avian structure that gives them ample space for engaging in their natural hunting behaviors, and the zookeepers would probably have to release tons of mosquitoes every day for them to catch. These structures also generally require branches, trees, bushes, and shrubs that attract the insects swallows feast on. This does not mean that swallows are never seen in zoos, but they're difficult to care for and not really a huge attraction. It's not very likely you will see them, and they are less commonly kept than many other bird species. The swallow is unique in its ability to live in close proximity to humans while lacking the capacity to thrive in confinement. On the other hand, their ability to live alongside us is limited, as human activities are taking a noticeable toll on swallow populations. Very few, if any, wild animals are immune to things like pollution, agriculture, climate change, and hunting, and swallows are no exception. Number 1. Giant squid. If you're hoping to witness a giant squid in person at any point throughout your life, let alone in captivity, I recommend not holding your breath. I hate to disappoint, but there are many reasons why this will probably never happen. For one, giant squids are among the animal kingdom's most elusive creatures. In fact, until 2004, researchers only had dead specimens to learn from. That year, Japanese scientists captured the first ever photograph of a live giant squid. The first video footage of one in its natural habitat was filmed in 2012. In June of last year, a giant squid was captured on camera in American waters for the first time. Scientists believe there are millions of them throughout the world's oceans, even though they are rarely seen. Besides being shy, giant squids typically live at depths between 1,000 and 2,000 feet and are thought to dwell as deep as 10,000 feet. This deep-sea habitat is another reason they are seldom spotted by humans. Giant squids will also probably never be placed in aquariums because of their size. The largest specimen ever found measured 59 feet long and weighed nearly a ton. These creatures have the largest eye in the animal kingdom, measuring roughly the size of a dinner plate. Scientists' knowledge of these creatures is extremely limited due to their evasive nature. Until recent decades, the giant squid was more mythical than anything. The fabled Kraken, the gigantic monster of Scandinavian folklore, which reportedly terrorized and tossed ships with ease, is thought to have formed as terrified sailors' explanations for giant squid sightings. Unless you're as lucky, or perhaps unlucky, as one of those sailors, you will probably only ever observe this frightening marine creature in photos and videos. Thanks for watching! Which one of these animals would you love to see in real life? Let me know in the comments below, and while you're at it, be sure to subscribe! See you next time! Bye!